Hello everyone, in this video we'll be learning the design of band and block breaks, and also we'll be solving a numerical in this one. So this is a combination of band type of break and block break. So here you can see we are having the drum which is rotating, and the breaking action is provided by the frictional contact with the drum by this block, and these blocks actuated by the frictional contact between this bands used, which is running over this block of frictional material. And as usual to the band type of break, it is these bands are attached to the lever, and this lever is pivoted about this point, so at the end of which the operating or actuating force will be applied. So here it is using the band as well as block type of frictional contacting surfaces. Then the analysis will be similar to the previous one. If you are having a band used, then you will be having two tension side, tight and slack. So you can have T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. But here this will be somewhat different. Suppose n number of blocks are used, and I can count it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to n number of blocks. And here if you are taking a single block, the block will be looking like this, or this block will be making an angle about the center of the drum. The total angle we will be calling it as 2 theta. So if I am marking this element here, so this block will be looking like this, and this will be making an angle of 2 theta about this center of the drum. And on one side you will be having the tension T1. This side I can call this the tight side. Here tight side can be identified easily, since this block is, since this drum is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, motion is coming, so tight side should come here. So you can mark the tight side tension T1 here, and just onto this side of this block I can mark the tension as T1 dash. This T1 dash is the slack side tension for this block. So you can have the ratio of tensions of T1 by T1 dash. And from the resolving and some derivation, you will be getting this expression as 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta. So this one is the ratio of tensions just on two sides of the first block that you are considering, where mu is the coefficient of friction, and here theta you can understand from this one, 2 theta is the total angle subtended by the a single block about the center of the drum. But here the previous expression that we have discussed in the band break is different. This theta is the angle of lap for the entire band about the drum, but here it is different. So in a similar way, if you are taking the second block, the second one, then on the tight side you are having the tension T1 dash, and then this side you are having the T2 dash. So for that case also you can use T1 dash by T2 dash equal to the same expression, 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta. In a similar way you can write for the last or the end block. And finally you have to evaluate the extreme tight side tension T1 divided by the other slack side tension T2. So T2 is coming here and T1 is coming here. These are the tight and slack sides. And this one, so this expressions are for each block. So if you are having n number of blocks, finally this will be equal to, we are having a final expression, 1 plus mu tan theta divided by 1 minus mu tan theta the whole power n, because we'll have to multiply. This T1 by T2 will be becoming T1 by T1 dash into T1 dash divided by T2 dash into etc. up to n dash divided by T2, like this one. So this will be coming Tn minus 1 dash divided by Tn dash. So this will be getting cancelled, and finally we'll be getting this T1 by T2. So that expression is coming here. So T1 by T2 will be finally equal to the 1 plus mu tan theta by 1 minus mu tan theta the whole power n. And this expression is the only difference from the previous cases. And this one you can use for evaluating the torque, which is equal to T1 minus T2 into the radius of the brake drum. So when you are finding the radius, this will be equal to the radius of the brake drum plus this thickness. So this is R and this will be T. So you can call it as R dash, which is equal to R plus the thickness of the block of material used. In some case they will be neglecting the thickness if it is very small. So this is the only different for this band and block bricks. So we'll be solving a numerical from this one. So here we have a problem from the band and block brick design. Here band is lined with the 12 blocks, that is the value of n, number of blocks is equal to 12, and each block subtends an angle of 15 degree at the center. That means the value of 2 theta is equal to 15 degree. So theta will be equal to 7.5 degree. That means the angle subtended by this each block about the center, this will, we are calling it as 2 theta. And the thickness of the blocks is 75 mm. That means this thickness T is equal to 75 mm. And the diameter of the drum is 850 mm or this radius is equal to half of 850, which is equal to 425 mm. When the brake is in action, the greatest and least tensions, we have to show that. That means this is a derivation. There is no need for deriving this one. You are already having the result from this discussion. So you just need to understand it is the ratio of tensions T1 by T2 equal to 1 plus mu tan theta, where theta is half of this 15 degree and mu is the coefficient of friction. And here we have to calculate the force, that is the actuating force P, which is required for this configuration or arrangement if the block is to absorb. Power and RPM ratings are given, and this can be used for evaluating the braking torque, and then we can evaluate this actuating force. So first I will be evaluating the braking torque, which is equal to, so this torque from the power and RPM we can calculate. So this is equal to 60 P divided by 2 pi n, because you are knowing that power is equal to 2 pi n T by 60. So this one you can substitute. 60 into power is 225 kilowatts, 225 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 2 pi into RPM is 240. So this will be giving you the torque in Newton meters, and that will be equal to 8957 Newton meters. And you are knowing that this torque is equal to the extreme tight side tension T1 minus T2 into the effective brake drum radius, which is the radius plus thickness of the block. So on the left hand side you are having the torque, which is 8957 Newton meter in SI unit, and on right hand side this R plus T is equal to 425 plus 75 mm. So 425 plus 75 mm is 500 mm, or which is equal to 0.5 meter. So from this one you can find the value of T1 minus T2, and that will be getting as 17,914 newtons. So we have to calculate the value of this tensions T1 and T2 independently. So for that, now we are having one equation, T1 minus T2 value. The other equation is T1 divided by T2 is the expression that was given, or that one you are knowing. T1 by T2 equal to 1 plus mu tan theta. That means 1 plus mu tan of 7.5 divided by 1 minus mu into tan of 7.5, the whole raised to n, number of blocks, it is 12. So this will be giving the ratio of T1 and T1 divided by T2, and that one you will be getting as 3.55. So now we are having two equations. One is T1 by T2 equal to 3.55, and another one is T1 minus T2 equal to 17,914. So this one you can solve simultaneously, and then you will be getting the value of this T1 and T2. So T1 is equal to 24,920 Newton you will be getting, and T2 will be equal to 7,020 Newton. So these are the answers. So from this one you have to calculate the final value of the actuating force P required. So for evaluating the P, you can take the moment about this fulcrum or pin for this tight and slack side tensions. Here you are knowing the tight side, because since this is rotating in the clockwise direction, so motion will be coming like this, and against this tension side will be coming here, and slack side will be coming here. So T1 is with respect to lever acting in this direction, and T2 in this direction. So T2 will be creating an anti-clockwise moment, T1 will be creating a clockwise moment, and this P will be also be creating a clockwise moment. So you can take the moment about the fulcrum, then you can write it as the clockwise moment T1 into distance is 30 mm or 0.03 meter plus P into distance is 500 mm or 0.5 meter equal to slack side tension T2 into 150 mm or 0.15. So in this you are already knowing the value of T1 and T2, and from this you can calculate the value of the operating force required P. So if you are substituting these values, then you will be getting the operating force as 610.8 N, which is the value they are asking for. So this is the answer, and hope you understood, and thanks for watching.